Hey guys, so I'm really excited to introduce our brand new book, ALM Modeling and Balance Sheet Optimization. This book is like a guide that combines theory with practical tips and code examples to help you build balance sheet models from scratch. In other words, it presents a mathematical way to simulate and optimize the dynamics of assets and liabilities of any financial institution. We put a lot of emphasis on using dynamic programming to give you a deep understanding of the banking problem, you know. We cover many things from data layers to decision variables, business and regulatory constraints, modeling strategies, debugging, and reporting. We truly believe that this book is valuable for professionals involved in things like integrated stress testing, capital adequacy assessment, financial planning, and optimization tasks. So, my colleague Diogo Gobira and I, Lucas Processi, have been working on this and other quantitative topics at the Brazilian National Development Bank for the past 15 years. We also run the Financial Risk Academy, where we provide training and consulting services in these areas, you know. So in the next slides, I'm going to walk you through the content of this new book we have just released, all right? Okay, so we begin the book by doing a sort of warm-up in the first chapters. In them, we introduce the ALM problem as a constrained mathematical optimization challenge and provide motivations for adopting a holistic approach. Then we present a set of modeling guidelines based on our experience with these models. Next, we give a brief review of the accounting concepts necessary for building a balance sheet model before offering an overview of mathematical programming and specifically the stochastic dual dynamic programming, or SDTP, which is the main tool we use throughout the book. Next, we explore the importance of organizing data pipelines to orchestrate a wide variety of financial data, assumptions, among others. And finally, in the appendix, we give you an introduction to the Julia programming language and all the tools you will need to understand the code examples we provide, okay? All right, now that we've covered all the primers, it is time to get our hands dirty, shall we? In this chapter, we're going to build a basic but totally functional balance sheet optimization model using Julia and SDTP. We'll show you a real-world mathematical model that can project financial statements, all while sticking to important accounting principles and financial rules, okay? We'll be using state and control variables to represent and manage the dynamics of balance sheet, income, and cash flow statements. The variables and constraints we discuss in this chapter, they're like the essential building blocks for any balance sheet model, regardless of the specific characteristics of the institution, you know. The idea is to lay a strong foundation for the following chapters when we'll be creating more sophisticated and specific constraints. So, we'll dig deep into a key model component, business constraints, you know. By adding these new rules to the model, it's going to go from being generic to becoming specific to each financial institution, right? Here, we'll enhance our mathematical model with growth rules, market limits, risk budgets, and other constraints, right? Adding realism, you know. And lastly, in this section, we're going to explore variations of the objective function that ultimately works like the compass that guides the optimization process of the model. In addition to list common constraints, here we'll refine your understanding of code structures and variables to empower you to create new constraints that better fit your own cases, right? So, in this chapter, we're going to dive into the world of uncertainty, you know. Given the unpredictable business landscape, it is crucial to consider uncertainty when making decisions. We're going to explore the structure and estimation of economic and financial scenarios that are what allow us to incorporate uncertainty into our balance sheet projections. Then, we'll show two strategies to actually program the uncertainty into our model. First, we explore the memoryless approach that works great when we want to focus on short-term projections, you know. Then, we dive into the Markov switching approach that can handle the notion of economic cycles, what is especially suited for medium and long-term projections. Okay, now that we've got our balance sheet model all set and we've taken into account the uncertainty surrounding it, it is time to unleash the power of SDDP to train and simulate your model, right? We discuss strategies for fine-tuning, training and simulation parameters to strike a balance between computation time and accuracy. We also provide guidelines and code examples for generating a wide range of reports with different levels of granularity. We also address a crucial topic, troubleshooting. We all know that even best-laid plans can encounter challenges, right? So we emphasize the importance of automated tests to catch any potential issues early on. And finally, we discuss various debugging strategies. All right, folks, to wrap things up, we really hope that this book is going to be a game changer for you when it comes to implementing, running, and maintaining those optimization models in your institutions, you know. So make sure to stay tuned to our social media channels to get all the latest news and updates about ALM and balance sheet optimization. Thanks.